A senior Philippine diplomat asserts the need for a peaceful resolution to the country's maritime row with Beijing. Foreign Affairs Undersecretary Teresa Lazaro made that position clear during the final day of the dialogue between the two countries.
Maritime issues continue to remain a serious concern to the Filipino people. Additionally, both our countries' leaders agreed that maritime issues should be addressed through diplomacy and dialogue, and never through coercion and intimidation.
China's Vice Foreign Minister Sun Weidong echoing that remark. He also hopes for more consultations with the Philippines on their long-standing maritime issue.
We need to properly deal with these issues through friendly consultations. This points the direction and provides the guidance for us to deal with and solve maritime issues between the two countries.
A former operator of offshore gaming in the Philippines reveals a scheme involving the alleged selling of Chinese workers to other POGO firms. Nico Bawa has this special report.
October 19, 2021, the Philippine National Police entered the office of Benistar, a licensed POGO operator in Zapote, Las Piñas. According to Ruth Pomposelli, the former operator of the facility, the police were looking for six Chinese workers who were victims of human trafficking. But she was surprised when several other employees were made to leave the building and brought to the Las Piñas police station. She says the PNP did not show her any documents of the police operation.
Sabi ko, sir, nasaan po yung papel? Ano po yung pangalan ng reklamo? Ano po yung identity? Wala rin silang formal na binigay.
According to Pomposelli, ever since the police operation, she has never seen her employees. She says she was only able to track them when they were brought to the DSWD shelter in Mandaluyong. She was not able to get hold of the employees and instead, she received a complaint for trafficking.
At hindi lang yun. You know what confused me? Nawawala yung mga tao ko. As in, nasaan? And then I found out na benta sa ibang POGO operator.
In a separate forum, Pomposelli says she tried to speak to some PNP officials so she can take back her employees. But she was asked to pay half a million pesos for each employee.
Bago pumasok ang mga e-workers sa ibang employer, may utang na kaagad sila na 600,000.
Yun.
Yung mga workers na yan, pipiliti nilang magtrabaho.
Non-stop daw na tayo. Parang slave labor.
Yes, magiging slavery. Kung gusto mong umalis sa akin, lahat ng binayad ko sa'yo, lahat ng mga inano ko babayaran mo. Ngayon kung walang pambayad, tatawag sila sa pamilya na sa China, sa kaibigan. Kailangan mong bayaran yung ginastos.
The complaint against Pomposelli was eventually dismissed. However, she claims an official initially tried to ask 20 million from her for the case dismissal. The PNP denied her allegations.
That's very unfair to the PNP for her to accuse the PNP of doing that. Siguro he should start naming names so that these people that he will be naming, they can also defend themselves.
The ground commander in the raid explained that it was the Chinese embassy who sought for their assistance, and they were accompanied by the DSWD in the rescue operation to find the six trafficked Chinese workers. He claims the other employees of the POGO insisted that they be rescued as well, which is why they took them into custody.
Pagkakit namin, nung nagkakandak na inspection yung ating City Social Welfare and Development Officer, nagulat kami, yung mga empleyado nila, nagbabaan na at gusto nang umuwi. And na-overwhelm kami. Gusto nilang umuwi na at ayaw na nilang magtrabaho. So, in-extend din namin yung aming tulong dito sa mga empleyado na to.
He also explained why Pomposelli was not allowed to speak to her employees.
Every time na nakikita nila yung mga yon, ng mga victims na na-rescue natin, bumabalik yung trauma nila. Sila mismo nagre-request na kung pwede, hindi sila makausap.
Pomposelli and the PNP also had a different headcount on the number of rescued workers that night.
58 lang siya talaga. So we have the records. We have dun sa police station, may records tayo. Hindi ko alam kung bakit niya sinasabing 72.
According to the DSWD, 6 of the employees escaped from their shelter. The remaining 52 workers were discharged last December 2021 and were brought to their relatives in Manila. The PNP doubts if the workers were sold after they were released, though they admit that this has happened in some cases.
All expenses paid ng company, yung accommodation mo, lahat sasagutin ng company. So siyempre bilang investor, ang ano mo, makabawi dun sa investment mo. Siguro kung hindi sila maging effective or hindi sila productive para mabawi yung ginastos nila sa'yo, yun yung parang sigurong kanilang option.
According to the data gathered by the ABS-CBN Investigative and Research Group, out of the 111 victims in crimes involving POGOs from January 2019 up to September 2022, 71 were cases of kidnapping and 40 others were human trafficking. Majority of the victims are Chinese nationals. More than 80% were rescued by the police. The others paid ransom or escaped from their captors. This data does not include cases from other units from the PNP and the NBI. Kidnapping and trafficking aren't the only illegal activities that have involved POGOs. Others were involved in online scams. Nico Bawa, ABS-CBN News.